Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, giving you tips and tools to get organized and get prepared. I'm topping off my preps and I've created a new area for my extended pantry, and I needed some more canned fruit. So I thought, let me go to the Dollar Tree and get some more fruit. And I decided to do a $20 canned fruit stock up haul. I do this so I can show you what is available at my local Dollar Tree. Let me know in the comments below what you have right now for canned fruit. I know during the spring and summer there were more choices. For example, there were mangoes, which I absolutely loved and wanted to stock up on more, but this is what I got. So they have been having Libby's sliced pineapple, which is great because you can always cut those up to a smaller size. They also had tidbits, but I decided to get the tidbits in those little containers. I'll show you in a little bit. They also have crushed pineapple. This brand, Island Choice, diced fruit cocktail, and this is in light syrup. Sliced peaches, I got a few of those during the summer, and these are in heavy syrup. There are also mandarin oranges. This is great for like salads or different recipes. And then there are also pears. The good thing with canned fruit for prepping, you can eat these right out of the can, or you can add them to recipes, or you can have them as a dessert or even a side. So for fruit, I also included the preserves that were on hand. These are strawberry preserves by this brand, Frutessa. They also had raspberry, and there is a grape jelly there too. And then I saw this apple pie filling. I thought I saw a cherry filling a couple weeks ago, but for now this is what my store had. And I actually went to three different stores just to see if there was a different variety, but this was pretty much all the things they had as far as fruit. And as I was saying earlier, these are the pineapple tidbits I decided to get. Now these don't last very long. They're June of 2021, so less than a year. So you want to make sure that you have those in rotation. And then I've had these peach cups before. These are good. I've actually had both before and they're pretty good. And again, these don't last very long, so make sure you're using up your preps. Another good reason to have canned fruit in your prepper pantry is that you can use them for baking and other dessert recipes. Okay, I'm gonna look at the expiration dates and show you. So this one is best if used by April of 22. And so this is great to stock up on because you may not have fresh apples. So you can do this for Thanksgiving, for future Thanksgiving, for apple pies during the summer. And then you can see this jam has best by July of 2022. So that's like almost 2 years. This is May of 23, March of 23. So you'll usually see most of them kind of have the same expiration date because obviously the delivery was the same. And this is August of 22. This is April of 23. Like the other cans, it will tell you produced the date and best by date. And this is May of 23. And this is best used by May of 23. Okay, so before I put this in my prepper pantry, I take a Sharpie and I face the can in front of me so that it's always the same area where I'm going to write the expiration date or best by date. And usually if it's a can and it has that metal part up here that's easy to read, I just put the month and then the year. So when I'm looking at the can, I know it's this way and I just look up on top and it's facing me. So something like this jar where maybe the red is hard to read, I can also put one here, 7 of 22 right on top. That's pretty easy. Or I find the front left corner that is white and I could put it here also. And for cartons, I write it on the top and I find the white space as much as possible. And then I put the date there. I've labeled all the cans with the best by, used by, or expiration date. And now I can put these into our prepper pantry. hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below which one you have in your pantry or which one you would get, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.